So today's topic is about gastrulation, and the gastrulation is marked by the formation of the three germ layers, which are known as ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. And to analyze the process of the gastrulation, the C. hn embryos have long been used as a model organism or a model system because of their transparency in gametes, structures, and simple organization, and their small number of constituent cells. So during the process of the gastrulation, the mesoderm and the endodermal cells, which have already been specified to each lamellage, move into the internal cavity of the embryo. So gastrulation mein kya hota hai? Ki jo future or the presumptive mesodermal ya endodermal cells hain, they move towards the interior or the internal side of the cavity of the embryo. Now it is known as the blastocene. ठीक है, सो ये सर्च सेल्स जो हैं विच आर ऑल्सो नॉन एज द ब्लास्टोडर्मल सेल, सर्च सेल मूव टू द इंटीरियर ऑफ द एम्ब्रियो ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ गैस्ट्रुलेशन. सो इन रिजल्ट ऑफ सेट माइग्रेशन, सो वन सेल लेयर स्ट्रक्चर और वन सेल थिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द ब्लास्टुला इज नाउ ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इनटू मल्टीपल लेयर्स सच एज द एक्टोडर्म, मेसोडर्म, एंड एंडोडर्म लेयर्स. अ फर्टिलाइज्ड सीएचएन एग अंडरगोस अबाउट द 10 राउंड्स ऑफ द क्लीवेज and develops into a spherical and hollow blastula, which is composed of a monolayered epithelium. So 10 rounds of the cleavage ke baad jo CHN embryo hai, now it's known as a hollow blastula. So this blastula consists of a single monolayered epithelium surrounding the blastocene. After hatching, the descendants of the large micromeres, primary mesenchymal cells, begin to migrate into the blastocene. So the first cells which actually migrate from the surface to the interior of the embryo are known as primary mesenchymal cells, and the primary mesenchymal cells are also known as the skeletogenic mesenchymal cells or the skeletogenic mesenchyme. So the first cells migrate to the interior of the embryo after hatching from the fertilization envelope, okay, and these cells are actually the descendants of the large micromere. As we had already discussed in the previous lectures, when we are talking about the fat maps, so the descendants of the large micromeres were in future forms the structure which is known as the larval skeleton. Okay, so after hatching, the descendants of the large micromeres, which are known as the primary mesenchymal cells, are also known as the skeletogenic mesenchyme. They begin to migrate into the blastocene. So the first kind of cells which migrate into the interior of the embryo or into the blastocene are known as the primary mesenchymal cells. So they migrate through the migratory movement, which is known as ingression. So the ingression of the primary mesenchymal cells is accompanied by the retraction of the anchoring microvilli from the hyaline layer. So as the primary mesenchymal cells are associated with the hyaline layer with the help of the protruding microvilli, and then also they are associated with the neighboring cells. Okay, so they have strong associations with the neighboring cells, and they are also associated with the help of microvilli to the surface hyaline layers. So when the ingression of the primary mesenchymal cells is accompanied by the retraction of the microvilli from the hyaline layer and the loss of the cell adhesions with the neighboring cells. ठीक है, so कौन कौन से events होते हैं जब ये cells जो हैं वो ingress करते हैं from the surface to the interior of the embryo or into the blastocene. Number one जो event है वो क्या है, retraction of the microvilli from the hyaline layer. Second event क्या है, loss of the cell adhesion with the neighboring cells. And third is the disruption of the basal lamina that coats the inner surface of the primary mesenchymal cell. ठीक है, जो बेसल लेयर है जहाँ जो कि कोट करती है प्राइमरी मेसेंकाइम सेल को, विच इज नोन एज द बेसल लेमिना. सो द थर्ड इवेंट इज द डिसरप्शन ऑफ दिस बेसल लेमिना. सो देन इट कॉजेस द इंग्रेशन ऑफ द प्राइमरी मेसेंकाइम सेल टू द इंटीरियर ऑफ द एम्ब्रियो और इनटू द ब्लास्टोसीन. द नेक्स्ट इज द रिट्रैक्शन ऑफ द सीलियम एंड द डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द माइक्रोट्यूब्यूल्स दैट हैड रिटेन्ड सेल्स इन द कॉलमनर शेप ऑल्सो अकर ड्यूरिंग द इंग्रेशन. So ingression is also marked by change in the cell shape. So cell shape is changed from the columnar to the rounded or circular in shape. So cells jo hai inki shape jo hai wo columnar shape se rounded shape mein jo hai wo change ho jati hai when they ingress into the interior of the embryo. So in result of such changes, the primary mesenchyme cells become rounded in shape, and then they slip or move from the vegetal plate into the blastocene. So such cells are located at the vegetal plate. So by changing the cell shape, then the cells ingress into the interior of the embryo. After the primary mesenchyme cells have migrated into the blastocene, the descendants of the small micrometres and also which are formed at the fifth cleavage and remain at the center of the vegetal plate. So when the primary mesenchyme cells migrated into the interior of the embryo, जब ये cell primary mesenchyme cells जो हैं ये interior of the embryo के अंदर migrate कर जाते हैं, then जो है वो remaining cells जो हैं वो कौन से cells हैं? Those are known as descendants of the small micrometres. ठीक है? और ये जो small micrometres हैं, now they are present at the center of the vegetal plate. ठीक है? So जब प्राइमरी मेसेंकाइम सेल्स माइग्रेट कर जाते हैं इंटीरियर ऑफ द एम्ब्रियो में, देन रिमेनिंग सेल जो कि वेरिटल प्लेट में द सेंटर ऑफ द वेरिटल प्लेट में प्रेजेंट है, दोज आर नोन एज द स्मॉल माइक्रोमीयर्स, डिसेंडेंट्स ऑफ द स्मॉल माइक्रोमीयर्स. बोथ द प्रोजेनी ऑफ द स्मॉल माइक्रोमीयर्स एंड द सराउंडिंग सेल्स एंड द सराउंडिंग सेल्स व्हिच आर नोन एज द VG2 लेयर सेल्स आर द VG2 ड्राइड सेल्स बिकम इलोंगेटेड देयर एपिकोबेसल एक्सिस एंड रिजल्टिंग इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द थिकेंड वेजिटल प्लेट. सो इन रिजल्टिंग क्या होता है कि जो सेल्स जो कि वेजिटल प्लेट के अंदर प्रेजेंट होंगे, दोज आर नोन एज स्मॉल माइक्रोमीयर्स आर प्रेजेंट एट द सेंटर ऑफ द वेजिटल प्लेट एंड देन सराउंडिंग द स्मॉल माइक्रोमीयर्स सेल्स आर प्रेजेंट, दोज आर नोन एज द VG2 लेयर ड्राइव्ड सेल्स. ठीक है? सो जो उनके सराउंडिंग में सेल्स प्रेजेंट होंगे स्मॉल माइक्रोमीयर्स के, दोज आर नोन एज VG2 लेयर ड्राइव्ड सेल्स. सच सेल्स ऑल्सो चेंज देयर शेप, दे कम बिकम इलोंगेटेड along their epicobasal axis and then resulting in the formation of a thickened vegetal plate. So again, they form a thickened vegetal plate. When they change their shape, they become elongated. So by changing their shape, such cells are formed in a bottleneck shaped cells, or such cells are known as bottle cells. ठीक है? बट चेंजिंग देयर शेप व्हेन दे बिकम इलोंगेटेड, सो एट दैट टाइम सच सेल्स आर नोन एज बॉटल सेल्स. सो इन एम्फीबियन एम्ब्रियो द एपिकल कॉन्स्ट्रिक्शंस ऑफ द बॉटल सेल्स लीड टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द डॉर्सलेट व्हिच मार्क्स द इनिशिएशन ऑफ द गैस्ट्रुलेशन. एम्फीबियंस के केस में क्या होता है कि जब बॉटल सेल्स फॉर्म होते हैं, सो देन इट्स इन रिजल्टिंग इट फॉर्म्स द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द डॉर्सलेट. सो दिस डॉर्सल लिप इज एक्चुअली द इनिशिएशन ऑफ गैस्ट्रुलेशन इन केस ऑफ एम्फीबियन. बट unlike the amphibians, in case of the sea urchin or in case of the echinoderms, the bottle cells are arranged in a circle at the central region of the vegetal plate. theek hai? So sea urchin ke case mein kya hota hai ki ye jo bottle cells hain, they are present at the central region of the vegetal plate, as in case of the Strongylus centrotus purpurator, that is actually a species of a sea urchin. theek hai? So in ke case mein kya hai ki ye jo cells hote hain, they are not form the blastulip, but these cells are actually present in the center of the vegetal plate. So bottle cells trigger the inward bending of the vegetal plates. So such cells initiate the inward bending or the invagination of the cells those are present at the vegetal plate. ठीक है? So bottle cells वो cells हैं जो कि trigger करते हैं invagination of the cells those are present at the vegetal plate. However, the cellular basis of the primary invagination cannot be solely ascribed to the bottle cells, because the invagination occurs even in the bottle cells depleted embryo despite a significant delay. So normally kya hota hai ki jo ye invagination hai, that is not solely described by the bottle cells. So not only the bottle cells initiate or responsible for such invagination, there are certain other factors that are responsible to carry out such invagination of the vegetal plate cells to the interior of the embryo. So within a few hours, the thickened vegetal plates bend inwardly and give rise to a short stub-like gut rudiment. So by the invagination of the thickened vegetal plate cells to the interior of the embryo, then a structure is formed, a short gut rudiment structure is formed by the invagination of the, or the by the inward bending of the vegetal plate. So by the inward bending of the vegetal plate, give rise to a short stub-like structure which is known as a gut rudiment. So the next is the Orchimchon elongation. So after the primary invagination is completed, then the length of the gut rudiment is scarcely changes during a couple of hours, and meanwhile the secondary mesenchyme cells become visible at the tip of the gut rudiment. So later on, kya hota hai? So first of all, the cells which leave the region, which are known as the primary mesenchyme cells, those are also known as the skeletogenic mesenchyme cells. So as the skeletogenic mesenchyme cells leave the vegetal region of the spherical embryo, important changes are occurring in the cells that remain there. Okay, and these cells become thickened and flattened to form a vegetal plate, and changing their shape, changing the shape of blastula. And then the vegetal plate cells remain bound to one another and also to the hyaline layer of the egg, and they move to fill the gaps caused by the ingestion of the skeletogenic mesenchyme cells. ठीक है, तो क्या होता है कि जब skeletogenic mesenchyme cells, जिनको हम primary mesenchyme cells कहते हैं, when they migrate into the interior of the embryo, then the remaining cells हैं, they change their shape and they fill the gap at the vegetal plate. ठीक है, and the cells become thickened and flattened to form the vegetal plate, and they changing the shape of the blastula. So later on क्या होता है, the vegetal plate cells involute inward by altering the cell shape, and then invaginates about the 1/4 to the 1/2 the way into the blastocene. So later on जो है, first of all the vegetal plate cells हैं, they involute and then invaginate to 1/4 to the 1/2 of the way into the blastocene. Then invagination suddenly ceases. And the, this invagination region is called as the Orchimchon. So what is Orchimchon? Orchimchon is also known as the gut rudiment, or is also known as a primitive gut. So this primitive gut is formed by the invagination of the vegetal plate cells. So how invagination is Orchimchon, which is known as a gut rudiment, or it's known as a primitive gut. This gut rudiment or the primitive gut is formed by, or Orchimchon is formed by the invagination of the vegetal plate cells. So the opening of the Orchimchon at the vegetal pole is also known as the blastopore. So the opening of the vegetal pole, or the opening of the Orchimchon at the vegetal pole, is known as blastopore. So meanwhile, the skeletogenic mesenchyme cells become visible at the tip of the gut rudiment. So you can say that the non-skeletogenic mesenchyme cells are the is the first group of the cells to invaginate, forming the tip of the Orchimchon and leading the way into the blastocene. So the non-skeletogenic mesenchyme will form the pigment cells, the musculature around the gut, and contribute to the coelomic pouches. So after the migration of the skeletogenic mesenchyme cells into the interior of the embryo, then such cells become visible at the tip of the gut rudiment. So ye cells, ye first cells hain jo ki migrate karte hain interior of the embryo mein. So jab Orchimchon form hoti hai, so at that time, so these cells are present at the tip of the Orchimchon or the gut rudiment. So as the skeletogenic mesenchyme cells are the first cells which are migrating to the interior of the embryo, so these cells are visible at the tip of the gut rudiment of the Orchimchon. So the skeletogenic mesenchyme cells extend thin and the long filopodia towards the animal pole side and exploring the attachment site. So later on, when these cells are moving into the interior of the embryo, then such cells extending a structure which is known as a filopodia. Okay, so such filopodia exploring the attachments to the interior of the embryo at the animal pole, while they retain adhesion to the gut rudiment. So later on, the phenomena is known as the secondary invagination. During the secondary invagination, the gut rudiment or the primary primitive gut, which is also known as Orchimchon, is now converted into a cylindrical elongated Orchimchon through a series of events are morphogenetic movements which are also known as the secondary invaginations. So it has been thought that the contraction of the filopodia connecting the archenteron tip and the apical plate pulls the gut upward. So the contraction of the filopodia to the animal pole or connecting the archenteron tip and the apical pole pulls the gut rudiment upward. So the filopodia जो कि फॉर्म होते हैं एट द सरफेस ऑफ द स्केलेटोजेनिक मेसेनकाइम सेल्स, सच फिलोपीडिया आर अटैच और कनेक्टेड टू द बेसल रीजन ऑफ द एनिमल पोल सेल्स, ठीक है, एंड दे आर आल्सो एसोसिएटेड टू द गट रूडिमेंट. सो सच कनेक्शंस कॉजेज द और पुल्स द गट रूडिमेंट अपर. सो इस टाइप के जो कनेक्शंस हैं, फिलोपीडियल कनेक्शंस हैं, ये पुल करते हैं गट रूडिमेंट्स को upward towards the animal pole. So in general, the height and the width of the embryo become larger during the gastrulation due to the expansion of the blastocene wall. So jab blastocene wall jo hai wo expand karti hai to jo height and the width hai embryo ki wo bhi gastrulation at the time of the gastrulation jo hai wo increase karti hai. So during the secondary invagination, the embryo height scarcely changes or decreases transiently. As part of the ectoderm layer to which the scletogenic mesenchymal cells filopodia adhere is flattened or depressed. So as we have already discussed that the scletogenic mesenchymal filopodia forming connections to the animal pole cells, so such animal pole cells are the future ectodermal layer. So ye jo filopodia hain jo ki scletomesenchymal cells ki surface ke upar appear hote hain, they connect to the ectodermal layer, theek hai. So such ectodermal layer is become flattened or depressed. So thus existence of the tension in the scletogenic mesenchymal cells filopodia is evident. So ek tension jo hai wo create ho jati hai between the scletogenic mesenchymal cells, and further the elongation of the archenteron is blocked and the pseudopodia or the filopodia are broken by expanding the blastocene. So later on such extensions or elongations are seized or blocked when filopodia और ब्रोकन बाय एक्सपेंडिंग द ब्लास्टोसीन. जब ब्लास्टोसीन एक्सपेंड करती है तो ये जो कनेक्शंस हैं बिटवीन द एक्टोडर्म, सच कनेक्शंस व्हिच आर फॉर्म्ड बाय द आर्केंट्रॉन टिप एंड द एक्टोडर्मल लेयर, एंड दीज कनेक्शंस आर फॉर्म्ड बाय द फिलोपीडिया, एंड सच फिलोपीडिया आर प्रेजेंट एट द सर्फेस ऑफ द स्केल्टोजेनिक मेसेनकाइम सेल. सो जब ब्लास्टोसीन एक्सपेंड करती है तो एट दैट टाइम ये जो कनेक्शंस हैं ये ब्रेक हो जाते हैं, ये फिलोपीडिया का स्ट्रक्चर है ये डिस्टरप्ट हो जाता है. सो दैट्स वाई जो है फर्दर जो है एलोंगेशन है ऑर्केंट्रॉन की वो ब्लॉक हो जाती है, सीज हो जाती है. सो एज यू कैन सी हियर इन दिस फिगर दैट द फर्स्ट सेल्स व्हिच आर माइग्रेटिंग फ्रॉम द वेजिटल प्लेट टू द इंटीरियर ऑफ द एम्ब्रियो आर नोन एज द प्राइमरी मेसेनकाइम सेल्स. प्राइमरी मेसेनकाइम सेल्स आर आल्सो नोन एज द स्केल्टोजेनिक मेसेनकाइम सेल्स. सो सच स्केल्टोजेनिक मेसेनकाइम सेल्स ingress into the interior of the embryo, then later on such cells develop the filopodia, and such filopodia explore the surface to the interior of the embryo or at the animal pole, theek hai, and then they form they are such primary mesenchymal cells are the scletogenic mesenchymal cells line at the lateral side of the embryo, theek hai. So and later on they form the skeleton or the larval spicules or the larval skeleton, theek hai. So ye jo primary mesenchymal cells hain jo ki actually mein scletogenic mesenchymal cells hain, jab ye anterior of the embryo mein move karte hain later on ye sites explore karte hain with the help of filopodia ki jahan pe jaake ye animal pole ke cells ke sath jaake attach ho jaye. Later on ye lateral side pe jaake jo hai wo attach ho jate hain to the surface layer cells, theek hai. और ये जो सरफेस लेयर सेल लेटर ऑन ये सेल्स जो हैं दे फॉर्म द सिनकाइटियल केबल्स एंड द फॉर्म एंड देन लेटर ऑन दे फॉर्म द लार्वल स्केलेटन आर द स्पिक्यूल्स. सो लेटर ऑन द सेकेंडरी मेसेनकाइम सेल्स जो हैं देन दे invaginate inside and these secondary mesenchymal cells are present at the interior of the embryo, theek hai, and then such secondary mesenchymal cells form the filopodia at their surfaces, theek hai, and then these filopodia form the connections to the apical plate or the ectodermal cells at the animal pole, ठीक है, एंड देन सो बाय सच कनेक्शंस दे दीज सेकेंडरी मेसेनकाइम सेल्स दीज सेकेंडरी मेसेनकाइम सेल्स एक्चुअली पुल्स द ऑर्गेनटॉन अपवर्ड टुवर्ड्स द एनिमल पोल. So it's caused the elongation or the extension of the orchestron. So next, as you can see here, that finally, the first opening which appears at the vegetal pole is known as the dorsal side. Is known as. So first opening, later on when the gastrulation is come in the later half of the gastrulation or the development, the first opening of the orchestron is becomes the aporal side, okay, and then another opening is appeared at the animal pole or towards the animal pole, and this opening is actually known as an oral it marked by the oral end or a mouth opening. So now the mouth opening, so as the sea urchin is included into echinoderms and they are known as the deuterostomes. So deuterostome jo group of animals hai unke andar first opening jo hai wo appear hoti hai, and in mein jo two openings appear hoti hai during the process of the development. So first opening jisko hum blastopore opening kehte hain, that is the opening of the orchestron, theek hai. And later on this opening becomes the aboral end, ठीक है, or the aboral opening, और जो mouth opening है या जो oral opening है, that is appeared at the opposite side of the aporal end. So secondary mesenchyme cells are known as students kindly correct this thing that SMC is marked by the secondary mesenchyme cells. They are not this abbreviation is not for used for the scatogenic mesenchyme cells. So this is used for the secondary mesenchyme cells, and the secondary mesenchyme cells are known as the non scatogenic mesenchyme cells. So first cells, those are migrating into the interior of the embryo, are known as scatogenic mesenchyme cells are known as the primary mesenchyme cells. So the later on the cells which are migrating to the interior of the embryo are known as the secondary mesenchyme cells, and the secondary mesenchyme cells are known as non scatogenic mesenchyme cells. So then the non scatogenic mesenchyme cells involute and they are present at the tip of the gut, and then such non scatogenic mesenchyme cells extend a thin and long filopodia towards the animal pole, and then exploring the attachment sites while they retain adhesion to the gut rudiment. And then secondary invagination, and then the secondary invagination, and then the tertiary invagination, that is marked by the connection of the orchestron with the help of filopodia to the apical plate of the ectodermal layer. Okay, so it's known is actually caused the final elongation or the extension of the orchestron. That's all for today.